Hello and welcome to Daily Reflection with Aneel Aranha. Today is the 21st of December 2018. We're going to reflect on Luke chapter 1, 39 to 45. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." The Gospel of the Lord. Luke begins his Gospel by introducing four characters: Zechariah, Elizabeth, Mary, and Joseph. Their individual stories are fascinating, as is their interaction with each other as their paths crisscross, linked by their own destinies and the destinies of their two sons, Jesus and John. When Elizabeth is approaching the end of her pregnancy, Mary goes with haste to her house, and not only does Elizabeth greet her warmly, she does so with honor. Scripture doesn't say much about any shame that Mary went through because of her unorthodox pregnancy, but there surely would have been whispers and they would have reached Elizabeth's ears. However, Elizabeth, quite familiar with shame, having gone through years of barrenness and the scorn of people around her, greets Mary with open arms, showing that she believes Mary's story, something that took divine intervention for Joseph to digest. It could have been so easy for Elizabeth to pour scorn upon the young child. Why would she do that? Because of jealousy, of course. Elizabeth too was blessed among women, given the gift of a baby by God in her old age. And we tend to be resentful when we find out that there might be others who are blessed in greater measure than we seem to be. But there is only joy in Elizabeth's greeting. "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb," she cries. Now, this is both a blessing and a prophecy, and I'm sure she must have contrasted Mary's response to the angel with her husband's response. While Zechariah, a high priest of God, was skeptical when the angel told him he was going to have a son, Mary, a simple peasant woman, merely asked for an explanation of what was going to happen to her and then consented willingly to the will of God. I invite you to reflect upon Elizabeth's words and actions today, because we also should be filled with joy whenever we come across a bearer of good news. Keeping aside jealousy and resentment, we should acknowledge people as being blessed, thank them for being blessings to us, and blessing them with everything good. Let me bless you now, and thank you for the blessing I know you are to so many around you. God be with you.